Lives, you're please asked to be seated. Please be seated. Andale pronto. Please make sure you also keep the distance required by the County of Fresno, 6 feet distance. I need to give instructions in regard to Holy Communion. The priests are to my left. First, the first section will come out and move to your left and come down to Father Sal Gonzalez, who will have the ciborium where you will reach for your host and go to the table to intinct.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
So wonderful to hear a lot of voices in church, and to see, if not an absolutely overflowing church, certainly full of your life, full of God's love, full of the joy that comes from living out the gospel, the joy that comes from the faith we have received, the joy of the priesthood, of marriage and the diaconate, the joy of religious life, the joy of our life together as God's people, His church. Nos hemos reunido en serio, hermanos, como el pueblo fiel del Señor. Es la iglesia, la familia de Dios. And Lord knows, as in any family, we sometimes have our differences, and each of us, in our own turn, we have our faults and failings. We have our sins. I know I do. I've been here long enough to make mistakes. When I first came here, everybody was happy. And some still are. Thanks be to God. But we're here to be faithful. All of us. So yes, of course, I've said things and I've done things that are difficult, sometimes hard to hear, maybe even disappointing. Well, it's my sinfulness too. But in this moment of silence, we lift up our lives as they are. We have come into this church as we are, como somos. El Señor nos va a transformar. It's the Lord who will transform us, who will heal us. He comes to announce good news, a year of favor with healing in His hands. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, I have gravely sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to life everlasting. Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe
Let us pray. O God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Lectura del libro del profeta Isaías. El Espíritu del Señor está sobre mí, porque me ha ungido y me ha enviado para anunciar la buena nueva a los pobres, a curar a los de corazón quebrantado, a proclamar el perdón a los cautivos y la libertad a los prisioneros, a pregonar el año de la gracia del Señor, el día de la venganza de nuestro Dios. El Señor me ha enviado a consolar a los afligidos de Sión, a cambiar su ceniza en diadema, sus lágrimas en aceite perfumado de alegría y su avivamiento en cánticos. Ustedes serán llamados sacerdotes del Señor. Ministros de nuestro Dios se les llamará. Esto dice el Señor: yo les daré una recompensa fielmente y haré con ellos un pacto perpetuo. Su estirpe será célebre entre las naciones y sus vástagos entre los pueblos. Cuanto los vean reconocerán que son la estirpe que bendijo el Señor. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
And my mercy shall be with him, and through my name shall his horn be exalted. He shall say of me, you are my Father, my God, the rock, my Savior.
Forever I will see the goodness of
Lectura del libro del Apocalipsis del apóstol San Juan. Hermanos míos, gracia y paz a ustedes de parte de Jesucristo, el testigo fiel, el primogénito de entre los muertos, el soberano de los reyes de la tierra, aquel que nos amó y nos purificó de nuestros pecados con su sangre y ha hecho de nosotros un reino de sacerdotes para su Dios y Padre. A él la gloria y el poder de los siglos. Amén. Miren, él viene entre las nubes y todos lo verán, aun aquellos que lo traspasaron. Todos los pueblos de la tierra harán duelo por su causa. Yo soy el Alfa y la Omega, dice el Señor Dios, el que es, el que era y el que ha de venir, el Todopoderoso. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to Nazareth where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Simon says, please be seated. I think I can preach from here safely without wearing this, but don't let me forget it. I don't want to get in trouble. I'm calling it my incense mask, because it works for that too. Cause for rejoicing. We do. In the midst of difficulty, in the midst of pain. We've been through it as church, as people, as a country, as communities. We've seen incredible tragedy and loss in Atlanta and in Boulder, Colorado, just within this last week. It's a sad story that is too often repeated. And brothers and sisters, in the midst of that, we hold on to a deep sense, we do, of confidence in God's love for us, and we hold on to a spirit of joy, we do. And it's not a coincidence, I don't think, that we're celebrating this Chrism Mass on another feast, the Feast of the Annunciation. Esta fiesta de Anunción, anunciando la buena nueva, anunciando el embarazo de la Virgen María, que iba a dar luz al Salvador. That is good news. You've heard me tell stories before about good news and bad news. Well, that is the good news. We're here, we're celebrating this beautiful Chrism Mass. We're celebrating priesthood in such a singular way, and all of our life and ministry in God's name. And good news that we're celebrating the Feast of the Annunciation. The bad news is we only have 282 more days of shopping before Christmas. Qué lástima, verdad? So with that in mind, do keep in mind my shirt size is large. My favorite color is blue. And You can never go wrong with chocolate. I'm just saying. Now, if I could see your faces without the mask, I would see a smile. I would certainly hope so. Because we must do everything with a spirit of joy. Priests and deacons, those of you who were accompanying the rest of us on that afternoon of recollection yesterday, where Bishop Trudeau said, when you renew your promises, you must do it with conviction and, yes, somebody was listening. Yes, conviction and joy. Con convicción renovamos nuestras promesas al sacerdocio, al diaconado, al matrimonio, al hecho de que somos creyentes, discípulos del Señor, inclusive esos seminaristas bien traviesos. No, they're actually very good. I'm so proud of them. And I'm proud of you, my brother priests. I'm proud of you, my brother deacons. So grateful to you, my sisters religious, so to all of you who are here this day. We have to make the effort to be joyful because it's not easy to do that. Because the world offers so many things that would cause us to lose that spirit, that would cause us to, in fact, hold within our heart the opposite spirit of cynicism and pessimism and negativity. And that's a spirit that dominates and a spirit that destroys. And that happens in our individual lives, it happens in our church life, it happens in our world, it does. So every day, and I see a few of the usual suspects here from the pastoral center, especially from my office, you know how I greet you every morning when I walk through that back door. Buongiorno, principessas. Good morning, princesses. And then when Father Sal is there, I say, buongiorno, principe. Prince of the church. Now, and he thinks he really is a prince of the church. I know, well, I'll take care of that later. I'll take care of that later. It's an effort to be joyful, and you have to make that effort every day. You've been told, I've been told 1,000 times, have a good day. Que tenga un buen día, que pase un buen día. And my reply to that, I try to remember to reply when someone tells me, have a good day, I only half jokingly and very playfully tell them, I intend to, because you have to intend such things. It's being an intentional disciple with a joyful spirit in your heart. You have to be very intentional. You have to really choose it consciously and with all of the grace that God provides us. We need to recapture our first loves, my brothers in the priesthood, my brothers in the diaconate, my sisters in religious life. We all need to recapture the joy, the excitement, the wonder of our first loves. When you first fell in love with another human being, and I hope you've all had that experience, I have, and the wonder of it, and the glory of it, and the joy of it. Deacons, when you first fell in love with your wives, and how you felt in the depth of your heart, and the questions that you were asking, is this the one? Is this the one, Heavenly Father? And maybe you weren't even asking the Heavenly Father those questions back then, but you certainly did, and you were asking those questions about priesthood and about the diaconate. When we fell in love with the church for the first time, with God's people, when we fell in love with the idea of becoming a priest or a deacon, and for many of us priest types, that began when we were real little, not for all of us, but for many of us, it started when we were small, cuando éramos todavía la mayoría de nosotros que pensamos en el sacerdocio, la mayoría empezamos a reflexionar, a pensar en el sacerdocio, cuando éramos todavía unos pueblos. Unos pequeñitos, when we were very small. A few weeks ago, I had a lovely, lovely meeting with one of our priests, and I asked him for permission to share this, and I wasn't even going to use his name, but he said I could use his name. So it's Father Ivan Hernandez, our pastor at St. Rita's in Tulare. And it's symbolic, my brothers, because I think many of you, if not each and every one of you, could tell a similar story. And it had nothing really to do with our meeting, but I just wanted to know a little bit about his vocation and how it started. And it started when he was little, even before he became an altar boy in a little town in Mexico. His parish priest got his attention at the Eucharist, specifically at the consecration. A little boy beginning to think, and this is the phrase he used, "I wanted to lift the chalice like him." Isn't that beautiful? It's another way of saying, I want to be like him when I grow up. We all have those stories. If you scratch the surface of a vocation story, there's always a person. Of course, the person of Jesus Christ, but there's always a human and someone who's only human. Not Dios y hombre verdadero, sino un ser humano en forma normalmente de algún sacerdote que nos atrayó a esa vida tan preciosa. There's always a priest involved somehow. In my case, to make a very long story short, it was my uncle John. And we never called him Uncle John. We always called him Father John, which was a problem for me when I became a priest. Because you know, brothers, you don't call another priest Father, you just call him by his name. It's a brotherhood, it's a band of brothers, and it's that fraternity that we not only talk about, but that we really try to live, and sometimes actually do live, truly. So, my uncle was so good. I wanted to be like him from the time I was a little boy. From the time I was the age of the seminarians, I wanted to be like him. When I was a young priest, I still wanted to be like him. He died in 1983 after 51 years of priesthood down in Los Angeles, and I was just celebrating my third anniversary at that stage, and I still wanted to be like him. Today, I've been a priest for over 40 years, and I still want to be like my uncle, because he's in the Hall of Fame. And honestly, I feel like I'm still in T-ball, you know, a little kid, and I'm trying to hit the ball and missing it still. I want to be like him when I grow up. So I don't have much more time left to grow up. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Seminarians, I don't want to scandalize you, but you will never stop growing until you stop breathing. And even then, you will be growing in God's love in heaven, because that's what God does, and that's what God will allow you and help you to do. It's everlasting life and love. So brothers and sisters, recapture the joy of your youth. Our joyful season is about to begin. A week from today, we begin the Triduum. We are reminded of Easter joy. This is a bit of an appetizer today. And in this Easter season, soon upon us, and in this blessing of the oils, we're reminded that good things come in threes. The three persons of the Blessed Trinity, the three theological virtues of faith, hope, and charity, the three oils that are about to be blessed, the 3 days of the Triduum, the threefold meaning of the anointing with chrism at baptism as priest, prophet, and king, every single one of us. And I believe also the threefold meaning of any anointing by any kind of oil that we might receive in our life. And it's those last two things I'd like to just end with. Yes, that threefold meaning of the anointing with chrism that we all received on the day of our baptism. Cuando fuimos ungidos con el crisma de la salvación, el día de nuestro propio bautismo, ungidos nosotros como sacerdotes, profetas y reyes. Yes, anointed as priests to serve and to sacrifice. Ser sacerdote es servir, es sacrificarse por el pueblo, por la gente. And that gets back to our first love, brothers, that we too easily forget. Ungidos como profetas, yes, prophets, to speak God's truth, to speak to the powers that be, to speak with great courage and be willing to pay the price. Listos, dispuestos para sufrir las consecuencias por decir la verdad, por ser testigos de la verdad, testigos de Cristo Jesús delante de todos, a pesar de las consecuencias del peligro. And anointed as kings, como reyes, pues mejor dicho para nosotros, príncipes, ¿verdad? Y princesas. We belong to a kingdom, we do. And as we participate in his kingship, we lead people to Christ. We guide them, we guard them. We defend the defenseless, that's what we do. And then finally, the threefold meaning of any kind of anointing. And I know I talked about this 2 years ago, but I wanted to repeat it. It's not original, it comes from a beautiful book entitled Traveling Light. It's by Max Lucado. He's a Christian, though non-Catholic writer, a pastor actually in San Antonio. I don't know where he finds the time to preach or even to sleep, because he's written so many books. But in Traveling Light, it's a reflection on Psalm 23. And line by line, he goes through Psalm 23. I highly recommend it. But the operative phrase today is, you anoint my head with oil. And he goes on to describe how there are three reasons why a shepherd, and remember we had those beautiful reflections yesterday from Bishop Trudeau about what it means to be a shepherd. And so Max Lucado talks about how shepherds, centuries ago, from antiquity, how and why they would even anoint sheep at all. What does that even mean, to anoint a sheep? Well, they were anointed because they would hurt themselves once in a while. It was like medicine. It was a soothing balm, como un alimento, como pues medicina para las heridas de las ovejas. So that healing touch, and that's what any anointing brings with it. It was also a kind of insect repellent, because I know Pope Francis is asking us to acquire the smell of the sheep. That means you, thank God, not real sheep. Because real sheep, they do smell, and you don't want to acquire that smell. So shepherds would anoint, literally, put some oil on the sheep to kind of mitigate that smell and to repel insects, little things that would bother them and distract them so much that if they add up, they could be distracted to actually going crazy from all of the little things that bother them. And isn't that true of us as human beings? And the anointings that we receive ought to help us with those little things. Just ask the people I work with. It's the little things that bother me. Isn't it, Mary, my executive assistant? She's going, yes. You didn't have to go, yes. You could have said, no, nothing bothers you, Bishop. No, it's little things that bother me. It's the big things that I can handle, seemingly. It's amazing. Thanks be to God. So if you have a big thing to bring, bring me a big thing. If you bring a little thing to me, watch out, I might get mad. Anyhow. And then the third reason for anointing of a not so much a sheep as a ram, the male of the species, because you know, boys will be boys, and they get upset sometimes. They get mad at each other, and they lock horns, literally, and they butt heads, literally. And sometimes we human beings do that, too. We have that phrase. These guys are butting heads. They're not good for each other, not good with each other. Well, shepherds would anoint the horns of a ram in the event that when they did try to lock horns, they couldn't. Or when they did butt into each other, they would slide off and not do as much damage. So brothers and sisters, we have been anointed priest, prophet, and king. We have been chosen to be joyful followers of the Lord and be joyful in the midst of difficulty and pain. I'm so glad we're here today. Last year, I think we were numb. I certainly was. I felt paralyzed in some ways, and you may have too. The sheltering in place had just begun. We were only beginning ourselves to learn what live streaming was about, most of us, myself included. And today we get to gather here. Si podemos reunirnos como en vivo. Bendito sea Dios, it's such a blessing. So at this time, I'm going to simply sit for a moment. I want all of us to remain in this moment, in a brief time of silence. Un momento de silencio antes de la bendición de los óleos, antes de elevar nuestros corazones todos juntos al Señor en una oración profunda y gozosa. At this time, I would ask my brother priests to please stand. Remember, with conviction and joy, beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on his apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promise you once made?
I am.
Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about sacred duty towards Christ's church, which, prompted by the love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination? Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls? And as for you, my dearest sons and daughters, those here present, please pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour his gifts abundantly upon them and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ, the high priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. And please pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my lowliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and the servant of all. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherds and flock, to eternal life. Amen. My brothers, please be seated. And now I ask my deacons to please stand. My brother deacons, day by day you have learned to live the life of the gospel and deepened your faith, hope, and love. Urged by the Lord's love and strengthened by the Holy Spirit, you are being asked this day to renew your promises. Therefore, I ask you, Are you resolved to continue in your ordained ministry for the church? Are you resolved in mind and spirit to give faithful service to Christ the Lord and to his body?
Amen.
Are you resolved to continue to share the burden of others and always to listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit?
Amen.
Are you resolved to continue to shape your lives according to the example of Christ, whose body and blood you give to the people?
Amen.
Are you resolved to continue to proclaim the faith in word and action as it is taught by the gospel?
Amen.
Deacons, God bless you, and please be seated. And now I would like any of our religious women, any religious men, to please stand. And don't go away. I need my mask. Don't go anywhere, James. So you know me well enough by now that I do go off script. But there's a method in this madness. Sister Gioviana, please come forward. Yeah, you. Come, sister. Now, Gioviana, it is so good to see you. Allow me to escort you forward. Now, if there's any other sister here, oh no, follow me, sister. If there's any other sister here present today celebrating 75 years of religious life or more, please come forward as well. Okay. So, sister, follow me. We have to go where the book is. And now watch your step. So, sister, if you would stand right here. And again, Sister Gioviana is symbolic of all of you, my dear sisters. Representa a todas ustedes religiosas aquí presentes. So, my dear religious sisters and brothers, the Lord Jesus calls men and women to follow his steps in the ways of ministry. The gifts you share are many and varied, bringing unity through diversity among God's people. Recognizing your religious calling, I ask you to renew your commitment to service in the church. So, sister, James, if you could show her that. So, you, sister, you're going to read that, and sisters all together, and brothers. Un aplauso fuerte para todos. Don't go. Gioviana, I'm not going to ask you how old you were when you entered, because then we could do the math and figure out your age. But God bless you for
thank
all
you.
Of
thank
those
you.
Years
thank
and
you.
Years to
thank
come.
You. Nice to see you.
Yes, thank you. Please be seated, brothers and sisters. Now I would like all of our lay people here present, los laicos, a que pongan de pie, que pongan de pie. Please stand, all of those. My dear brothers and sisters, through baptism, God enlightens everyone who comes into this world. We have responded to the grace of your baptisms, and through your particular calling in life, you bless the church with your talents and ministries. Recognizing the Lord Jesus' call in your lives, I ask you to renew your commitment to service among God's people.
To God's people, and I ask you for the grace to be faithful to this commitment.
Together, we form the body of Christ, who continues to redeem the world by our share in his ministry. May the Lord, who has begun the good work in us, bring it to fulfillment. May the Lord in his love keep you close to him always. May he bring all of us, his priests, deacons, religious, men and women, people, everyone, to eternal life. Amen. And again, let us show our support and appreciation for one another with another round of applause. O God, Father of all consolation, who willed to heal the infirmities of the weak through your Son, listen favorably to the prayer of faith. Send forth from the heavens, we pray, your Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, upon this oil and all of its richness, which you have graciously brought forth from the verdant tree to restore the body, so that by your holy blessing, everyone anointed with this oil as a safeguard for body, soul, and spirit may be freed from pain, all infirmity and all sickness. May your holy oil, this oil of the sick, O Lord, be blessed by you for our sake. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. O God, strength and protection of your people, who have made the oil you created a sign of strength, graciously bless this oil and grant courage to the catechumens who will be anointed with it, so that receiving divine wisdom and power, they may understand more deeply the gospel of your Christ. They may undertake with a generous heart the labors of the Christian life, and made worthy of adoption as your sons and daughters, they may rejoice to be born anew and to live in your church through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, to God the Almighty Father, that he bless and sanctify this oil. May those who are signed with it outwardly be inwardly anointed and made worthy of divine redemption. O God, author of all growth and spiritual progress, receive in your goodness the grateful homage that the Church joyfully offers to you through our voice. For in the beginning, you commanded the earth to bring forth fruit-bearing trees, among which olive trees would arise as providers of this most rich oil, so that their fruit might serve for sacred chrism. In the spirit of prophecy, David foresaw the sacraments of your grace and sang of the oil that would gladden our faces, and after the world's offenses were washed away by the flood, a dove announced the restoration of peace on earth with the olive branch, foreshadowing the gifts to come. In the last days, all this has been clearly revealed when every offense is removed through the waters of baptism. The anointing with this oil makes our faces cheerful and serene. You also commanded your servant Moses to make his brother Aaron a priest by pouring this oil upon him after he had been washed in water. Still greater dignity was added to this when your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, insisted that he be washed by John in the waters of the Jordan. You sent the Holy Spirit from on high in the likeness of a dove. You declared by the witness of the voice that followed that you were well pleased in him, your only begotten Son. And you were seen to confirm clearly what the prophet David had foretold in song, that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness above his companions. Therefore, we beseech you, Lord, be pleased to sanctify with your blessing this oil in its richness, and to pour into it the strength of the Holy Spirit with the powerful working of your Christ. From his holy name it has received the name of Chrism, and with it you have anointed your priests, prophets, kings, and martyrs. May you confirm the chrism you have created as a sacred sign of perfect salvation and life for those to be made new in the spiritual waters of baptism. May those formed into a temple of your majesty by the holiness infused through this anointing and by the cleansing of the stain of their first birth be made fragrant with the innocence of a life pleasing to you. May those anointed with royal, priestly, and prophetic dignity be clothed with the garment of an incorruptible gift in keeping with the sacrament you have established. May this oil be the chrism of salvation for those born again of water and the Holy Spirit, and may it make them partakers of eternal life and sharers of heavenly glory through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Say
Oren, hermanos, para que este sacrificio mío y de ustedes sea agradable a Dios Padre Todopoderoso. Amén. May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself. so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
as God's people, as God's family, como miembros de una sola familia, la familia de Dios, vamos a rezar todos juntos a la misma vez en nuestro propio idioma, en las palabras que nos enseñó el Señor Jesús. We're going to pray together all at the same time in our prayer language, our own language, together in words Jesus has taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins.
Behold the Lamb of God, el Cordero de Dios. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Señor, yo no soy digno de que vengas a mi casa. Una palabra tuya bastará para sanarme.
Ah. Dominus Angelicus, fiat panis hominum, dat panis celicus, figuris the same. Will you kiss such as this unseen and admit to what I mean in you and you in me. Will you love the you hide if I but call your name? Will you quell the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around through my sight and touch and sound in you and you in me? Lord, your summons echoes true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go where your love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow in you and you in me.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve, a te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes in hac lacrimarum vale. Eia ergo advocata nostra illos tuos misericordes oculos ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O
A note of thanks to Bishop Armando for being here, my predecessor. Also, many thanks to Monsignor McCormick, everyone here at Holy Spirit for helping and organizing. Father Robert Borges, you've had a busy week. Thank you as well. My lovely staff at the Pastoral Center and so many who helped to make this possible. A round of applause for them. Un aplauso fuerte. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Longing for light, we wait in darkness, longing for truth, we turn to make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Our world is troubled, longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us, make us your living voice. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Church gathered today, Christ.